Hi folks, this is Checkpoint Quiz 11.7. We're given a complex number and asked to pretty much run the gamut on it. So in part A, we're asked to plot Z in the complex plane. So what's the complex plane? Well, we take the two-dimensional axes. We associate the positive, or the x-axis rather, with real numbers. So this is the real axis, and the y-axis is the imaginary axis. And so we associate the point, the complex number 3 minus 3i, with the point 3 comma negative 3. So we march over 3 and march down 3. And so that's the point there, 3 minus 3i. Okay, in part B, we're asked to find the real part of Z, the imaginary part of Z, the modulus of Z, and the argument of Z. So if you rewrite Z in the form A plus BI, it's 3 plus negative 3i. The real part of Z is A, and the imaginary part of Z is B. So in this case, the real part of Z is 3, and the imaginary part of Z, the coefficient of I, is negative 3. To get the modulus of Z, we take the square root of the real part squared plus the imaginary part squared, or if we write it in the form A plus BI, it's A squared plus B squared. So here it's 3 squared plus negative 3 squared. That gives me 9 plus 9, that gives me 18. And the square root of 18, well, that's 3 square root 2. So the modulus of Z is 3 square root 2. What's the argument of Z? Well, thinking ahead to the polar form of Z, the argument of Z is the angle we would use with this value for R if we converted this point to polar coordinates. And since it's a capital A argument, that's the principal argument. So that's the angle between 0 and 2 pi. So what I need to do to find the argument is I imagine this as the terminal side of an angle, and I need to figure out what angle theta we've got here. So just like with polar coordinates, the tangent of theta is equal to the y value over the x value. So that's negative 1. And an angle in quadrant 4 angle, whose tangent is negative 1, between 0 and 2 pi is 7 pi over 4. So that gives me the capital A argument of Z is 7 pi over 4. So with the modulus and the argument in place, I can now write down the polar form of Z. For part C, how do I get the polar form of Z again? Well, I take the point. If I have Z equals A plus BI, then that corresponds to the point in rectangular coordinates, A plus BI. So I can find the point that corresponds to it in rectangular coordinates, polar coordinates. And the R and theta I pick, Y equals here, to get the polar form. The R and theta I pick is R is the modulus and theta is the argument. And so the polar form then, Z equals the modulus R times sis theta. Okay, so here's my modulus and principal argument. So the polar form of Z is 3 radical 2 sis 7 pi over 4. Now, even though we're not asked to do so, let's go ahead and check our answer by expanding out what this means. 3 square root 2 times cosine 7 pi over 4 plus I sine 7 pi over 4. That's what sis means. Sis, remember, means cosine plus I sine. Okay, that's what sis is short for. And so we get in there 3 radical 2 times the cosine of 7 pi over 4, square root 2 over 2, plus I times the sine of 7 pi over 4, that's negative square root 2 over 2. So as I multiply this together, I get 3 minus the radical 2 squared is 2, that cancels, so I get a 3 there. Here I get a negative 3, so I get back to z. Okay, so that's the polar form of z. And now we're going to use that polar form and DeMoivre's theorem to get z to the 4th power. Okay, I've got z is 3 radical 2 cis 7 pi over 4. I want to find z to the 4th power. So what's DeMoivre's theorem tell us? Well, it tells us if I have z written in polar form, then I can take z to the nth power . So that's r cis theta, to the n. That is r to the n cis n theta, where n is any natural number. So in this case, I want z to the 4th power. So that means I'm taking 3 radical 2 cis 7 pi over 4 to the 4th. So I take the modulus to the 4th, cis of 4 times the angle. All right, so let's work this out here. What's 3 radical 2 to the 4th power? Well, it's 3 to the 4th power times radical 2 to the 4th power. And what's 3 to the 4th power? Well, that's 3 times 3 times 3 times 3. So 3 times 3 is 9, 27, 81. What's radical 2 to the 4th power? Radical 2 times radical 2 is 2, and I square that, gives me 4. And so what do I get out of this? I get 324. Cis 7 pi. And we're asked to write our answer in rectangular form. So I go back and expand this out. This is 324 times cosine of 7 pi plus I times the sine of 7 pi. So 7 pi is an odd multiple of pi. That means when I graph 7 pi in standard position, it's going to end up on the negative x-axis. So cosine is negative 1. Sine is 0. And so when I simplify this, I just get 324. So that'll do it for part D.